Hello, let's try a demo now. This is a weird one because there are currently about three West games. What are the three West games? Well, it's Blood West, Weird West, and Evil West. I'm not sure which one of them will be the best one, but I think the best one will probably have a lot of details that you'll see. Now, as you can see, this is kind of like a cute lady, right? Also increase the gamma. So you can see in the menu, this is a cute girl, but if you see the increased gamma, you see something weird over here. Yeah. Kind of like this detail. So this is the default. As you can see, it's very bad visibility. Now this is kind of like a weird combination of a shooter with a, I don't know, looter and maybe a little bit of a survival. So let's click new game, start. I think it will put us in the tutorial and then we'll get to play the game a little bit. But I don't really understand the difficulty system because it seems overtuned for now. Hey, we fell down.
Back again.
I like the voice. I like the voice a lot. Death and curses. Yes, we might get cursed.
Oh, it worked. It worked. And is oh me? You mean us? Nothing but an amalgamation of. The answer is you're undead. We brought you here by means of our immense powers from whenever place you've been before. We know of your exploits and achievements. Your fame reaches wide across the country. Before you ask, no, we cannot send you back. Not yet. And a reason you have. As an undead outside of others' influence, you will be our torch in the dark. Your spark will become the flame to purify the rot of this world and free us from the unending cycle of despair. Search for the evil lurking in.
Wow, that was a lot of dialogue. I guess you have to sneak since you don't have a weapon.
That'll come in handy.
Yeah, the game is pixelated, but that's not the problem. It reminds me of that other West game with the pixels. That was such a cool game. If you're wondering, yes, he can hit us if we get too close, so don't get close. As you can see, this is more like an RPG system, or I don't know, an RPG inventory, or I would say even a survival game. Okay, that guy doesn't shut up. I have a bandage, okay. Let's continue. Also, we are bleeding, so let's heal the bleeding with the bandage. Can also loot them, which is the funny thing because they don't seem to have any loot on them, but hey, they do. I guess they have hidden pockets, don't ask me where or how, but they do. Nothing over there.
Whatever gets the jobs done.
There are also different types of ammo, gold and short ammo. Melted cursed gold. Oh, okay. Well, it looks like
good.
Somebody tried. By the way, this gun is loaded, as you can see from the lower right. It has 6 bullets. Yeah, it's a great game, but I think it will have to. We'll have to wait until the full release because I'm not sure if this will be playable or not playable, I don't know. It just depends on a lot of things and a lot of stuff, because right now I wouldn't put my hand in the fire, that's an Romanian expression for any game. So yeah, don't count on any game being released very soon or super 100% sure. Well, let's rest first of all, because we are tired.
New fates around these parts? Come in. It's safe here, unlike most of this area. Listen, there really isn't much to say. You certainly figure this place ain't normal or safe. Don't expect a warm welcome for the locals either. But if you know your stuff, you can make a coin or two pillaging and scavenging. Or killing monsters if you're so inclined. If I were you, though, and if you really want to get to the heart of the evil, well, you're on a good track. There's an old burned church around here. But where's the money in that? Better to find whatever you can, sell it, and leave the damn place to rot for all I care.
And now we begin the trading. As you can see, this is not our inventory because there is too much loot in it. Not anymore, this is about 15 gold. I played a little bit before the video. If you click on the item, it will say stuff. Let's just sell it. Probably the thing we need to buy in the beginning is a lot of ammo. As you can see, it will highlight the gun and its ammo. So this is short ammo, normal short ammo. That's golden short ammo. You can see it's 150 gold. This is only 30 gold. We have 65 over there, so... take the ammo. The amulets are also very expensive, max stamina, but they do give you a lot of benefits. Regen 1 HP per 2 seconds, effect doesn't stack, so I guess I'll need to have $250 and then the game will become a lot easier, I mean the demo. 1 HP per 8 seconds. What's the difference? Well, I guess if you want to... oh, okay, if you just want more HP regeneration, you'll have to go for that one. Now, there are a few houses in the distance, but I think they are a little hard for us. This here will be available in the full version, okay. So I'll try to not go to the house, because there are some crazy people over there, which will shoot us in a second. Or 2 seconds, depends on how fast they are. As you can see, we have a few icons in the middle. They will show if you are heard or seen, so be careful. Somebody was shooting at me.
Eat lead.
I love this reloading animation. I don't know what the skull icon is. That is a... oh.
Your pain will be much worse.
Oh, she has a shotgun.
Land of you.
Prodigal daughter, So, rusty shotgun. It still works somehow. I guess we can put that over there and kind of forget about our melee weapon. We're not going to have a lot of success using that. I'm not sure how long I'll play the demo, because if I die, I don't think I want to restart it. I'm pretty sure if you go and restart the... if you go and rest in the bed, you restart the demo. Let's not make noise. This game really makes you feel afraid. Like I said, I'm not sure about the difficulty in the full release of the game, but for now it's overtuned, I feel like. Point where I'm afraid to go inside.
You can never have too much of those.
By the way, the game is a little darker. Right now I'm using the increased gamma from the OBS. That was a headshot. I don't think I want to play the piano. That was so... I don't know, the game does a good job of being scary, but like I said, it depends on...
Whatever gets the job done.
And if they keep this difficulty level or they reduce it, because I think they reduce it, this is super dangerous. So what did we get? More ammo. How much ammo? Oh, silver short ammo. Damage to spirits, so I think you'll need to change your ammo based on what you're fighting. I guess this is all the loot you're going to get from this place.
Can always do with some more bullets.
I like his voice so much.
That'll come in handy.
So we need 250 gold. Well, I guess we fully looted the place, but let's look at the battles for a little bit, because this is what I like about the game. The story, the immersion. Well, the story is not much of a story, but you know, it's carried by its immersion.
A lady to rest.
By the way, aiming is a little weird, so... I don't know. I hope this is only a PC game. On consoles it might be even weirder.
I will rid this land of you.
By the way, on the bar, on the building over there we'll have shooters, which are very fast birds. Ouch.
Bleed the freak.
That lady chasing us with a shotgun was one of the most scary things I've seen in a very long time. Oh, this was a barman. Oh, nice. He dropped an artifact. Well, I don't think I want it just for now. Barman. So what is this? A rusty revolver. Well... I guess they should mention the damage of the weapon itself. Yes, you can also unload the ammo from them, which I've been. This is perfect. This is one of the things I love about the game. We also have the journal and the effects. I think the game will be so much more complex later on, but for now, this is kind of it. Look at the size of their claw. The size of their claws. Some items do stack, yes. I guess the bandages mostly. Okay, let me close my window. So as you can see, this is kind of like a sneaking game, or you can play it full guns blazing, but that will not be recommended, at least not in the beginning. Oh, the chest is empty. And you know how I learned to be so stealthy? Well, in the beginning, I think I died about 5 times and I stopped playing the game.
Wretched's death. One and done.
I'll not go to rest because, like I said, I'm not sure if that will reset the enemies as well, so I'll not take my chances. I think those guys are patrolling up there. Mild effect due to short distance. Huh, so I guess you do less damage if the distance is too big. This is not Escape from Tarkov, we cannot loot close. That was empty. Okay, let's give it another look at this building and then employ more. As you saw, there is no... Oh.
Oh, good. Ammo.
There was no immediate healing. That was healing over time as well. So I think that... There are... Oh.
Oh, good. Ammo.
Wait a minute. Did I not see all of that ammo? Well, I guess it's pretty hard to see in the dark. I mean, if you want to see how dark it is for me, let me default this. Yeah, this is how dark it is. Come on. I'm also not cheating. My monitor is just what you saw over there in the recording is exactly what I saw on my monitor. My monitor doesn't have increased gamma to compensate for that. What I can see, there is one big guy left over there. Yeah, let's just click on take all. I love the fact that you can loot everything, because usually these games have a problem. You kill something with a gun and it doesn't have the gun when it dies, but not this one. All miracles. So I finished that first building, the second. Oh, hey, a lucky coin.
That'll come in handy.
I guess you can set up a lot of ambush points, because the shotgun lady could have been easily killed by you if you just go on,
whatever gets the job done.
On the roof like here. Oh, nice. So if you sneak around and get to the roof over here, you can basically pick off all of your targets from over here, even on that building where the birdman will be. Yeah, I'm taking it very, very slowly, because this is kind of like a new experience for me and I want to enjoy it. Oh yeah, this is definitely got some interesting stuff going for it. Oh. Okay, just a lonely skeleton over here, no loot to be seen. Yeah, it reminds me so much of that game, I don't know what it's called, but it was, you know, pixelated, and if you played it, you remember it. The one that had a secret alien level in the fountain. The one where the bullets were shown as cards. Yeah, I guess I've said enough hints. I just don't remember it right now. I'm also pretty stressed about playing this game. Because when I played it the first time, all the time I would come over here and those barmen would shoot me to pieces.
You can never have too much of those.
Okay, so I do have golden ammo and some other stuff. Yeah, ammo is super important. So that's another rusty revolver. Well, let's just check everything. Like I said, it's going to be a fun ride. I don't think the demo is too long, so that's why I want to make sure I get everything, or most of the things. Stamina doesn't seem to be a big problem. I mean, unless you're running away from something really big and mean. Okay, so they can die with a headshot, but you have to be very on point with the headshot. You have to be on point with your headshot and also be at a good distance. If you are too far, it will not do full damage.
Whatever gets the job
done. I can see a rifle over here would be so much better. So can you go on the roof of this thing? Oh, that's a nice cowboy hat. Can I take it? At least there's a souvenir. Okay, so there's nothing on top. Well, for the sake of the video, we'll try. Okay, we cannot shoot that thing down. And also, this is a two-action revolver. I think you pack the gun and then you shoot it. It's not one of those single action revolvers, which is also, I think that was a semi-auto. You can call a single action a semi-auto. It's so much brighter if you're not over there. To be honest, I don't think there is anything over here. So let's run back to the merchant. Let's sell all of the pistols. Oh, that's animated. Nice. I'm pretty sure we just have... Oh, that scared me a little bit.
Keep your eyes out. Once I thought of...
So let's see, 35. So a rusted pistol is $10. Doesn't seem like I'm... Okay, I can modify his inventory. Shotgun. So that's a normal shotgun, and this is probably a rusted shotgun. It might do more damage. I just hope they add the numbers. I like to see a lot of numbers. For example, I want to see how much do I get for every item, and also how much damage does every item do. Short ammo, nice. I guess the maximum stack it's 14. Well, you can have the cup. I have it especially for you. I think this is a random drop. You can get it or you cannot get it. Okay, so they unstack if you put them over there. So what should I buy next? I think, well, I said... Oh, 130. We'll buy nothing. And let's go. I've been playing for 25 minutes and I'm still afraid of the game, so okay, let's see if we can finish the demo, or I'll just play as long as I can. What's the point of stamina? Looks like I can run with zero stamina. But it might not work exactly as intended for the demo. Well, I guess we all know what this is used for, and it's also... was slightly moving in the wind. Oh, it sees me and it hears me. I guess I don't have a shot.
Let's put these to good use.
Well, is there anything else on the other side of the train? Probably. Something sees me.
You could never have too much of those.
Okay, so this is a standard shotgun. Good thing I didn't spend my money on it. Beautiful animation, exactly as I expected. I guess those are the spirits. Yeah, I don't like the spirits. Basically, the spirit, I saw them in the trailer. The spirits are kind of like floating skulls, and I don't like enemies that are not solid. The game did such a good job of introducing you to the solid enemies. And imagine going to floating skulls after that one. Yeah, it's going to be scary. Just going to be tedious.
You're not welcome here.
Okay, I missed a few shots, but that's okay. The birds tend to move their heads a lot. Huh. Okay, we can walk on the edge of the...
can always do with some more bullets.
Thingy. Well, might as well shoot them from here.
And stay down.
I think I missed a few items here and there, but overall I think I'm doing a pretty good job at clearing. Also, I really hope the game keeps its open world exploration, because this game would be terrible if it was in close quarter, because all you had to do is shoot and dodge, shoot and dodge. Okay, so let's say we explore this part of the map until there. What's seeing me? Let's check under the... under the thing. The gallows. And I think this is called the gallows. By the way, it's kind of midnight over here, so that's why...
we'll need that.
I'm super immersed in the game and I'm really not making noise or running. Not sure what these are. They look like empty food cans. So, from what I understand, we have to use the silver short ammo on the spirits. And probably the gold ammo on... I guess it's good damage against everything. I guess that's a simple book we cannot read or pick up. I guess you have to go up the path. Ah, so there's something inside? So if they fire the bullets, okay, he didn't get to fire a single shot. I think if they don't fire at you, you'll actually get more ammo.
This time, stay dead.
Which is a great reason for you to be stealthy, because if you kill them without getting shot back, you'll get more ammo.
Let's put these to good use. I will need that.
Looks like something was in the dungeon and something decided it didn't want to be in the dungeon anymore. Yeah, the game is so freaky with the noises. I like the voice. I think this reminds me a lot of the Duke Nukem voice actor. It might be the same, but I'm not sure. At least that's what I think. That's why the voice sounds familiar to me. Empty chest. There's nothing more disappointing than an empty chest. Well, looks like this one is kind of like from the main menu, because you see that huge, grotesque arm and the modified leg as well. Right there, straight from the main menu. Okay, this looks empty.
Can always do with some more bullets.
Something is trying to see me.
You can never have too much of those.
Golden nuggets. We have struck gold. So good. Oh, cursed gold. Unrefined and slightly more reddish than you'd expect. Yeah. I don't want to shoot a bottle, but I assume it will break, or maybe it will not break for now. Oh, wait, did he have a star? Yeah, I guess he was a sheriff. Or a deputy. Okay, so we basically looted the entire city. We have killed, what, 15 monsters or something like that? It's so scary in the beginning when you have a few bullets and an axe and they say, hey, see that? Go over there and tell them you love them or whatever.
There is something odd about you.
Okay, looks like he empties his inventory after a while. Okay, maybe it should be enough to have 250. So, 1 HP per 8 seconds, effect doesn't stack. 1 HP per 2 seconds, so why would you buy this one? Because it's a lot cheaper? That could be a reason. This one is for stamina, if I remember correctly. Yeah, that's not really worth it. I guess I should buy more golden ammo. Or more healing. Now it looks like I'm pretty well prepared this time. Can I save the game?
You made it. You came here. Ah, we could. Could we? Yeah, we seek the cursed gold. You got the gold? Bury it beneath his totem and we shall be shame. Talk to...
Huh. So 105 gold is not enough. I need more. Probably 100... I don't know. I'll just have to come back when I have more shiny cursed metal, as they call it. That's actually a very good description of what money is. Except for the shiny part, because now we have bills. Or paper money. Well, is it worth it looking on the train as well? Might be... Okay, I see something on the train. Something also broke out of the train. Wow. They destroyed the roof. I'm not sure how I was supposed to go on the train. Okay, let's give it a try. Probably it's a small puzzle of some kind. But I'm pretty sure it's not possible right now. Maybe with some really cool jumping. Yeah, probably not in the game, but that's only a teaser. Maybe you just have to jump. Okay, let's try it. Why not? Sorry about this. It's a slight detour. Maybe, no, it doesn't look like we can jump from anywhere. I mean, we'll give it a go, but... Oh, it might work, it might work. I think I found it. Oh, this regenerating health is sure very, very helpful. No, of course, the pacing for the full game might be different. Oh, this might be also very hard.
Let's put these to good use.
What was that short ammo? I guess that was regular ammo. Okay, let's go to the destroyed church. A bad feeling that we'll need to kill all of... Yep, this is not as effective as I would have liked it. Actually doing a very good job at hunting me. Oh, I'm sorry, did you run out of ammo? Yeah, the shotgun is probably only good at point blank, or at least if you can shoot them in the head, or... I don't know. That was a failed ambush. Yeah, let's take this and we'll...
One and done.
Oh, okay, they don't need a lot of shells to be killed. Yeah, they're actually very hard to hit if they come towards you like that. Okay, let's get that extra ammo we need. Oh wow, okay, that might be a little problem. Looks like the game pauses when you're in the inventory. They actively can tell when they're targeted. Yeah, I don't like that design. So they actively auto-dodge you when they can't feel it. Don't tell me I have to go underground. That's the worst thing I could do right now.
I will need that.
Oh, a golden chalice, a golden cup. Well, since I have the auto... But, oh no, it's not going to attack me. Oh, it can phase through the walls. So this thing will be annoying forever if I don't shoot it.
And stay down.
We'll visit that place a little later.
Let's put these to good use.
Ectoplasm. Crystallize in time. Good luck. Oh, I like this one. So the enemies will have a bigger chance of missing in the range attack.
Ooh, good.
Oh, looks like we can have a stack of five in a Wait, what? Okay, so they only go up to 3 stacks. Nah, that's nice. Is it worth going back again? Probably. Let's see if we have to go into the hidey hole. That sounds like a cursed weapon. Small veins are visible on the wooden handle. So headshots will make you regain HP. Oh no, where? Well, I guess the... man, really? It bugged out and the shotgun disappeared. But why? This normally works. I guess it's the demo, it's not going to be perfect, so... Yeah, we can drop this on the ground, it will fall down.
Good.
But it said it might be cursed, so I guess it's good we didn't pick it up. Yeah, I don't see any penalties for stamina. I guess... Ooh, let's see what the cursed shotgun does. Well, the headshot's 5 HP, that's not a lot.
When I am done, listen, and if you really...
Hey. Feathers are all yours, also the golden chalice, so $300.
We hear buzzing, a blessing. You got the gold, bury it, shame.
Not enough gold, not even
there
now.
There's something odd about you, listen, and if you really...
Yeah, stamina seems to be not implemented right now, so there's no point in buying anything like that. Also, this says effect doesn't stack, so even if we buy 2 of them. But I guess we can try, but I'll believe the developers when they say it doesn't stack. Wendigo Heart, Shadow Heart. Yeah, let's go back now and let's go inside the hall. Wow, I didn't expect to play this for so long. I guess I'm afraid of what might be next. The game is not very hard, but... You can die in a heartbeat. You saw how much damage those things did to me. I mean, the skulls don't do as much damage, but the crows, the birds, so... Let's search for the cursed shotgun again. It's not here anymore, okay. Understand what happened, but I guess we didn't headshot him like the other time. It's just better to shoot them in the head unless there are a lot of them. Also, I don't like the winding tunnels, but what can we do? Yeah, you recover so slow after a failed attack. So let's keep out of melee, at least for the tutorial or for the demo. Don't have any loot, that's too bad. Normally I'd be 100% follow the light, but in this case I'm not sure. That looks like a possible way down. Okay, so now I understand. Super ineffective to shoot them without aiming on at the head level. Yeah, this, I hate mazes. I hope they improve this design.
A wretch's death.
I hope they don't include a lot of platforming because this is becoming weird as it is. You're playing very well, you have a lot of fun, and then suddenly... Oh, would you like to make a hard jump and see what happens? No, I don't want to make a hard jump to see what happens. I have to finish the demo. Yeah, I think I'll just take this pathway because it seems it's mildly safer. Yeah, if they see you don't have a chance to fight them, I guess it's one of the more realistic shooters. Didn't see that other bird, man. Yeah, the shotgun is super needed. Also, I'm not sure if you can cancel your reload. Don't do that. If you can cancel your reload animation. Okay, game, you have me scared for my life. I hope I don't do a boss battle.
Splat! Get back to hell!
I assume that was not the last one. Yeah, no enemy is too small to be killed. I mean, this is not an arcade shooter where you can just kill everything. Even a single enemy can kill you if they take you by surprise, so let's go. Yeah, that was a mistake.
I'll rid this land of you.
My curiosity almost got the better of me. Okay, no more healing potions, but I do have a lot of bandages. I thought there would only be one of them. Now, if I was playing on my own, I'd just go back and resupply, but since I'm not playing on my own, I'll not bore everyone with going back to resupply. I guess this was just an alternate pathway that you shouldn't really take. Looks like this is a way out. Doesn't seem to be anything over here, so I guess we can exit the place super quick if we need. I guess we should have golden shotgun ammo since we have more than the regular stuff. But I guess it was cooler to have the church services here. Maybe I'm supposed to go that way because I don't see anything over here. I mean, it's... Well, those things are definitely not human, or at least not all of them. I see some... Oh, I guess we cannot interact with that one. I guess our only way forward is to go on the right. Okay, game, sure, we'll go to the right. Well, I might have missed a few things here and there, but I guess this is the only way to progress, to make the progress we need. I'll be disappointed that I lost that cursed shotgun, but eh, what can you do? To explore the dark world of the Bloodless across different realms. Well, that was a bit scary. I think I shot it in the head and it might have died, or that might have been a boss. Okay. Well, full demo completed. Let's look a bit at the options. Well, I don't see any difficulty settings if you choose to load your game. Oh. So you have an option to new game or load game. What happens if I load my game? When did I save? It seems like my strength has dwindled. Oh. Looks like I'm dead. So what happens if you die? What are your effects? Noxious. Clumsy. Well, that's actually very bad. It'll make more noise, you have less stamina, and also less health. Oh.
Lament your poor. It could be arranged, yes. We would even do it. Let's see. We need feathers. Their properties will help us drive the curse.
Well, Oh, okay, so in order to get rid of the curse, we need some feathers. I guess it counts as a death. And yeah, everything respawned. Well, exactly as I thought. I guess you can replay the whole thing if you want, but not for me. Fun game. Yeah, definitely need to be super careful, as you can see. Stealth is the only way in the beginning.
Meet the creeper.
So if you die, yeah, exactly. You don't really have enough for... You don't really get your ammo back, so you don't have enough things to fight. You'll have to use your axe. That would be terrible.
I may be going in. You have the eyes of a...
So you can buy them back for a worse price. Anyway, that's enough. See you next time. Bye.